for the generalizations here, I've cleaned up the language a bit. I want to share with you some descriptions of major religions today. Taoism. Stuff happens. Then Buddhism. What is the sign of stuff happening? Hinduism. This stuff happened before. Islam. This stuff happens if you didn't know about it. Protestantism. That stuff happened to someone else. Catholicism. This stuff happened, you deserve it. And last but not least, Judaism. Why does this stuff always happen to us? Well, let's pray. Holy One, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, God, one of you. Albert Einstein once said, there are two things that are in the universe and man's stupidity. And I'm not sure about the universe. What part of love God and love your neighbor do be not dead in me? My house will be called a house of prayer for all people. In each of the four Gospels, Jesus is reported to have repeated this text when he went to the temple. God is very good at drawing inclusive circles of love. I want to share with you this kind of love poem that I found, and it's anonymous. I couldn't find it. He drew a circle that shut me in, shut me out. Parents, brothers, a clean flock. But love and I have been given. We drew a circle that drew me in. The world is forever drawing circles that shut people out. In a polite way, we say, my invitation only, or deserve. Prejudice and pride draw circles that exclude people from God. But the very nature of God as universal in love and truth points to the all-inclusivity of God's reign. And we say here, God's kingdom. My house shall be called a house of prayer for all people. God's house is a house of prayer. And prayer indicates relationship, communication, and communion with God. In other words, God wants all people to be in fellowship with God, regardless of race, sex, books, nationality, class, health, education, age, or any class we can think of. God is for everyone, and everyone is about God. So how big is the house? We know that we can pray anyway, right? So what if the whole world is meant to be a house of prayer for all people? What if planet Earth is meant to be God's house of prayer for all people? Today, we know that the Cloud City is at least in part a house of prayer. A house of prayer for all people because of the efforts of the one that we honor today, Rabbi Henry J. Karp. Reverend Roy Livingston, a former MCCQC pastor, recalls that Rabbi Karp was the first woman to offer us a place to meet after our church fire in Rock Island. MCCQC met there on a Wednesday evening following the fire, and it was a great outreach to us because it greatly helped make our people feel we were not alone. Roy also passed along to another man. When the temple and Rabbi Karp and his family were receiving threats, Roy mentioned that he and his family, or that Rabbi Carpenter's family, could come and stay with him and Mark if they needed a place of safety. Henry joked and replied, I think a little partially joking, that'd be great, Roy, then they could just firebomb our house and get rid of all of us at the same time. When I came to the Cloud City as the pastor of MCCQC, I hadn't been here long when I was invited by Henry to come and be a part of the progressive clergy. It was great to be included and to be a part of that historic group that has done many good things in the Cloud City. Too many to count are all of various initiatives that Rabbi Karp has helped spearhead to make our Quad Cities more inclusive, welcoming, and just place. In 2003, in the midst of the Iraq War, Henry wrote to the Quad City Times, and I quote, "In a typical Jewish worship service, there are at least three times that we offer prayers for peace. Indeed, the concept of shalom, peace, is central to Jewish worship, and more importantly, Jewish values. Perhaps the Jewish devotion to shalom is the result of the painful reality that for so much of Jewish history, the gift of shalom has been denied us. Periods of peace, of quiet, and calm, such as we do experience today in the United States, are like honey on our lips. So we savor it, we pray for it, and we thank God for it every chance we get. But our history does not cause that at all times real evil stalks the earth, evil we dare not ignore. Therefore, even while we pray to God, spread over us the shelter of your peace, we also sing the song of the sea, sung by Moses, Miriam, and Israel, and all Israel, as they stood on the shores of the Red Sea, rejoicing for having been saved from the wrath of the Pharaoh's army. But even as we sing our song of celebration for the victory over evil, we keep in our thoughts a second century rabbinic commentary on that passage, in which it states that as the Israelites sang and danced, the angels in heaven joined in their merriment, and seeing this, God sternly rebuked the angels. How dare you sing while my children are crying? Our God is all. We are all God's children, our adversaries as well as our allies. We dare not forget that, even when we find ourselves forced to stop. All of that was Rabbi Karp. Henry often speaks for those who are voiceless, and he has championed so many causes over his 32 years of service as rabbi at Temple Emmanuel. I am so glad that even in retirement, Henry will continue to work on the One Team Family GCA. As he recently wrote in a thank you letter to the Quad City Times, "While Gail and I may be retiring from our professional responsibilities at Temple Emmanuel, as people of faith and conscience, we will never retire from our relationship with God through our chosen spiritual path, nor will we ever retire from our mission to work for justice in our community, our nation, and our world." Yeah. I have to tell you, I was a bit overwhelmed. I stole this from the table when we were watching the family meeting last Tuesday. And I'm in awe of what it is in this little book. I grabbed it because I thought it was going to have some stories about him that I could share. But instead, standing with my congregation in times of joy and sorrow, a two-year life cycle of retrospective, has for 32 years of all of the people that Henry has touched in his own congregation, the Temple of Emmanuel, all of the weddings, all of the funerals, all of the bar mitzvahs, all of the baptisms, and some other stuff that I don't understand. It's an impressive legacy. Now, originally this award to Henry was supposed to be a surprise. I had Gail in on it, and she had the family in on it. But getting Henry here proved to be a problem, as he knew the family was going to be in town, and he told me about the many times that he had to be called away from his family because of his position. And he didn't want to take one more minute of time away from them. Before we present this award to Henry, I want to invite Gail Karp to come and sing, and we've picked out songs. She has an allergic condition and is unable to sing for us today. But she did pick a great tribute song for Henry. So, providing we have some technical difficulties, this Henry Karp, who has helped like so many animals of hope. This is...